Sounds
good. Afternoon. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. How you doing today, sir?
I'm good. I'm good. I'm happy to be alive. Okay. Happy to be alive, brother.
Praise God.
Thanks.
I'm with you on that. I see you out there doing some commerce for yourself and all that.
Yes, sir. I have to go down to my. I have to go to my connect downtown Brooklyn.
Okay, I could dig it. So, sir, tell us, who are you and what do you do besides shop?
Right now, I'm the owner and operator of Jeff Hunt Traditional Shotokan Karate and Fitness and Kickboxing on Merrick. I'm the owner for 25 years in the community of Laurelton, training adults, children to become more aware of who they are and how their place in society is waiting for them. So I empower people through martial arts and boxing, and I'm also a professional life coach.
Wow, that's wonderful. So what do you like most about your current pursuit?
Helping people, bro. Being allowed to be connected to so many different journeys over 25 years, seeing so many young folks that were babies now, grown-ups, productive, successful people, and never forgetting. And there's not too many things that you're allowed to do in life that gives you an opportunity to connect and empower people and actually have the blessing of seeing what you've had just a little piece of influence in their life. So it's the most grateful thing is just being a part of so many journeys.
Wow, that's awesome, man. Thank you. Thank you for all that you're doing, especially with the young people. But tell me, like, you're a life coach, you're a fitness instructor, boxing coach, martial arts instructor. You're the owner and operator of an establishment in Laurelton. Who has been your greatest inspiration in business so far?
You know, years ago, I'm going to say Reginald Lewis, man. I used to read a lot of Black Enterprise magazine. And when Reginald Lewis cut that big deal with Beatrice, I was like, yo, I could do this. I could do this. And I tell you a funny story. When I took marketing in Queensborough College, I had a professor in a sales course. He was a white guy. One day he came in with a toupee on. The next day he came in with a bald head. And I was like, well, why the heck he do that? And he was like, because yesterday I had to deal with some younger people and today I had to deal with some older people. So I had to make different changes to make sure I got my sale. And he said something to me. He said, if you look at life is about a sale. Everything is about a sale. Everything you approach is a sale. When you meet somebody, it's a sale. When you talk to somebody, it's a sale. You know, when people are watching you, it's a sale. Life is about a sale, because if you present yourself the best way the first time, they'll always be bought by anything you want, anything you introduce.
Wow, I like that.
I think I gave you too much, but yeah, that's what it is.
No, but I'll take it, brother. I will receive it graciously. Now, you mentioned Reginald Lewis. Is that the brother who wrote the book, Watching White Guys Have All the Fun?
Reginald, I believe it was Reginald Lewis that cut the biggest deal in history.
With Beatrice
Foods. Yeah. I lived and died by Black Enterprise magazine in my 20s. I lived and died by that magazine.
Yeah, I had the opportunity to meet the late great Earl Graves.
Oh yes,
senior.
Oh wow.
With the pork, with the mutton chops and everything. I met him. I was starstruck. I was like, Earl Graves, you know. But brother, I'm not gonna keep you. But before I let you go, there was somebody here at Urban Upbound. You have some familiarity with the organization. Can you tell us who you know and, you know, what's up with that?
The great Bishop, help me out.
Mitchell?
Mitchell Taylor. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. I remember in my former life when I had the opportunity to be a part of the community of Astoria, in a law enforcement capacity, I remember the beginnings and I remember meeting him, and God has been good to me. I saw him, you know, continue to improve the community by different programs that he did. You know, I went to his church a couple of times in full uniform. You know, you can discern his love for the community and his ability to preach, his ability to preach. He had a way of bringing people together, and from what I understand, God has continued to bless him and his family, and he's grown astronomically, which, you know, it's well deserved. His work ethic was quite respected.
Well, that's great. Do you have any words for him that you want some little hellos? I'll make sure that he sees this.
Just give him a salute. Okay. Give him a salute for me and say hello. And of course, I'm just wishing and hoping and praying that God is being good to him and his family.
Okay. Well, Sensei, I really appreciate you taking time to give people a little taste of what's to come on June 9th. So you stay out there. Don't spend all the money. I'm a financial counselor, so I need to tell you that. Don't spend all your money. And bless you, brother, and enjoy the rest of your day. Keep safe out there, okay?
I definitely appreciate you. You may have to talk to me about this Bitcoin craze. We may have to have a conversation about that, all right?
All right, brother. Much love and respect. Thank you.
God bless you. Thank you.